the guerrilla moved from this area, but they're not gone, gone, you know? So there are certain areas in Colombia where you're not allowed to go on with a helmet. I'm not pretty sure whether we are allowed to wear a helmet in this area or not.Good morning, people. It's 7:15 in the morning, and today is day two of exploring around San Jose del Guaviare. We're leaving the parking lot. We're going to be taking an off-road pad all the way to a very amazing place I'm going to tell you about on the way there.Okay. Can't see anything. Everyone in this town starts working really early. The marketplace is open. You know, all the meat shops over here, supermarket over here. Everything is open early. Fresh avocados. Buenas!The place we're gonna be visiting today, it's called Cerro Azul. It's a mountain that hosts very, very ancient paintings from the indigenous community that inhabited this area thousands of years ago. These paintings are said to be over 15,000 years old, you guys. Those are pretty ancient paintings, and today we're gonna be discovering that place. We are gonna be driving through this kind of road maybe for about 20 to 30 kilometers.This place is just starting to open for tourism, so you don't find a lot of information online. So they told me basically you have to go to the place, we'll have to leave the bikes there, and we're gonna have to go across the jungle up the mountains to find these paintings. The road doesn't look so bad yet. There's a lot of rocks and sands, and from time to time we find these paved partsThere's absolutely no one out here. This view, it's absolutely stunning. Just, we're in the middle of this road here, in the middle of nowhere, and the only thing you can see over there, it's jungle. Trees everywhere, literally. Amazing. Why not?I'm not pretty sure whether we are allowed to wear a helmet in this area or not. It says it is forbidden to fish, to hunt, to have the cows on the road, to move the cows after 6 p.m. You cannot ride a car with dark windows, and you cannot carry closed helmets.Doesn't say we can't ride with a helmet on. It wasn't very clear from the sign. So just as a little bit of context, there are some areas in Colombia like this area, like I told you before, this area was basically dominated by the guerrilla for years and years. The peace agreement was signed. The guerrilla moved from this area, but they're not gone, gone, you know? They still inhabited farther areas, deeper in the jungle. So there are certain areas in Colombia, I read about this before, where you're not allowed to go on with a helmet. And if you're driving on a car, well, you just need to keep the windows open at all times. The only way of being sure about if it's safe or not is just asking around. That's how I assess security. You ask the locals, as many people as you can, because many people say different things. And some told us that it was better to ride without a helmet. Others said it is totally fine. We saw people going that way. They had a helmet on. So I guess as long as we keep this open, it's gonna be okay. But yeah, they're not gonna mess with you, you know? They're deeper in the jungle and their business has nothing to do with you. But they still want to know who goes across this place, you know? They still wanna know you're just a tourist. that you're going to explore, and that's totally fine. The area is safe. I mean, otherwise I wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be here because I made sure about that. I asked a lot around, and yeah, I guess we're just gonna keep on riding and see how it goes. Beautiful birds, those bluebirds. The entrance to the place might be somewhere around here. Maybe up ahead. Is it here? This restaurant, maybe? I gotta ask around, I guess.
Buenas.
Bien,
bien, gracias. Te pregunto para ir a Cerro Azul.
Sí, bienvenida. Están en la vereda Cerro Azul. El encuentro, la entrada a las pinturas rupestres, se van aquí adelantico, encuentran una casa de dos pisos bonita, ahí les dan toda la información.
Ah, ok, a mano izquierda está la casa.
A mano izquierda.
Ah, ok, vale, muchísimas gracias, muy amable.
Gracias. Oh, God. We need to wait here. Let's turn off the bikes because it might get scared.
Por este lado?
Vale. Ah, pero ya viene subiendo por la izquierda. Do not move, boot. Do not move. Oh man, that bull is huge. He was huge. Attends, t'as fait le demi-tour, mais ouf. We gotta go back a bit until this bull can go through. Oh shoot! Okay. Bye, buddies. Man, they're huge.
¿Va para el perro?
Sí. La entrada es allá, me dijeron, ¿no?
Aquí adelantito. Ahí antes, un poquito más adelantito dice información.
Vale, gracias. Oh, it's close, man. I think we made it. It's here, you guys. Did it.
Buenas. ¿Cómo
amanecieron?
Muy bien, gracias. ¿Y usted?
Gracias.
Yo aquí los registro y de aquí salen para el sitio que van a ir a visitar en compañía del guía local de aquí.
We got a ride for 4 more kilometers, and then there's a place where we can leave the motorbikes and everything. And then we'll start walking from there. Oh, there's barely any sun coming in here and it feels so good.
Amazon 熱帯雨林のこの地域のちょうど間、境目にいるらしいんですよね。なので、植物とか、まあ、動物などもまた変わった生物がいろいろ見られそうです。もうすでにこういった木に巻かれたツタとかはすごいこうジャングルっぽい雰囲気だけど、けどまたこう乾燥した感じの気候ですね。
Les presento a nuestro guía, Oscar. ¿Cuántos años tienes?
18.
¿Y tú naciste aquí en el Guaviare?
Sí, soy de aquí en el Guaviare.
Ah, bueno, súper bien. Entonces, Oscar nos va a estar guiando hoy, nos está contando la historia de este sitio y con él vamos a hacer la caminata hasta las pinturas de Cerro Azul. A esta zona no podemos entrar sin guía. So I was asking Oscar about his perception on safety here. He's 18 years old. He grew up in this area and it's very interesting what he says because he told us he felt very safe. He's never had contact with the armed force of Colombia. Wow! This is the main paintings, yeah. The ones that are the best preserved.
この絵はなんといくつもの原住民のコミュニティによって描かれたみたいです。たった一つのコミュニティじゃなくて、この下側の赤くなっているところはおそらく最初に描いたコミュニティの絵が、その次に来たコミュニティの原住民のコミュニティによって消されたんじゃないかっていう仮説もあるらしいですよ。手形があったり動物の絵があったり、僕はここに何時間でもいれます。何時間でもいて、彼らはどんな思いでこれを描いたんだろうっていうのを想像しながら見るのがすごく楽しいです。すごいところを今歩いてますよ。洞窟の中にたどり着きました。
Into this cavern, it is really, really dark over there.
And it's super windy.
okay.至るところからコウモリの声が聞こえてきます。おい。おお。うお。大量。やばこれ。
This is a lizard, a pegaf. And this is super low here. Wow, man!
Combien de mètres?
300 mètres sur le niveau de la mer.
Oui. Wow! 一面木、山が一切ありません。ずっと見える限り、ずっと木が熱帯雨林です。
There's someone actually burning down the forest over there, and apparently it is really forbidden. So if someone from this area speaks.And says something about that guy is gonna have to go 20 years at least to prison. All these areas here in the background where there's no forest at all, where nowadays there's cow, is to be covered by coca plantations. And the reason why this jungle here still survive is that during the rainy season, this thing floods everywhere. So if farmers at the time were to plant coca, it wouldn't survive. So it was not worth it. So yeah, thanks to that, we still have this jungle here alive.Farmers at the time, when this was all coca around here, could make around anywhere from 1 to 3 million a month with 1 hectare of land. Now, with that amount of land, they cannot make not even 1/10 of that, having to rent that space for the cattle business. So that is a big problem here. And Oscar was telling me how even if some people benefit from the tourism coming here,not all communities are in the tourism business, so they still have to find other ways to make a living.
Wow! 超はっきり見えます。くっきり見えます、絵が。わあ、美 美しい、めちゃくちゃ美しい。
We made it back to where we started the walk. What an incredible place to visit. Honestly, it's worth coming here, especially now that there's not many people visiting this area. You got like basically the whole place to yourself, so it was amazing.
I can love it.
This lunch looks very, very yummy. Super good. This soup. I don't know what's that called in English. I think the main ingredient for this soup, no idea, but it's really good.
Gracias. Gracias. 一体何のスープか分かりませんけどすっごい美味しい。今から町に戻ります。来た道とは違う道で帰ってみたいと思います。もちろん選んだ道はオフロードでございます。檻の後ろにいるから砂煙がすごい問題はここら辺全くインターネットがないんですよ。もう道が Google マップで調べられなくて道を聞きました。うおうおすっげーじゃん来た道よりも砂がすごいです。本当にたまに砂浜みたいなところがありますからね。うわ危ねえこれ。オリちゃんその道正しい俺も笑ってる場合じゃないんだけどね。オッケー。すごい景色です。すごい眺め。あの山の岩肌を見てください。ふわ絶対これ深いっていうかこれ海みたい。ビーチよこれ。メイン道路にぶつかりました。 OK オフロード終了です。戻ってまいりました。すごい旅だった。すごい最高に面白い道だった。ありがとうございます。ちょっとねバイクがすごい汚くなったんで洗ってもらいます。見てオリのバイクすごいことになってるんですよ。しかもチェーンもこんなになってるんで一回きれいにしてもらってオイルをつけます。いやなんといっても今日見た壁画はすごかった。もう本当にすごかった。 あれが2000年前のものなのか1万年前のものなのかまだミステリーです。ただ彼らが伝えたかったこともよくはまだ分かりません。ただ分かることは、伝えたかった、彼らもいろんなものを伝えたかったんです。そしてあれを見ながら僕らもいろんなものを伝えたいと、だからこうやって YouTube をやってるんだっていうことに改めて気づかされました。これからも面白い動画どんどんシェアさせていただきますよ。
So if you like this video, guys, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and also subscribe down below to the channel. See you in the next adventure. Ciao! Ciao!